In this video, I will talk about observing Markov chains and the fundamental matrix. Many interesting applications of Markov chains involve chains in which some of the states are observing and the rest are transient. This type of Markov chains are called observing Markov chains. Observing Markov chains are not ergodic. If we begin in a transient state, eventually we are sure to leave the transient state and end up in one of the observing states. Let P be the transient matrix of a discrete time Markov chain with S states. The transition probability from state I to state J is denoted by element Pij. Assume it is an observing chain with M observing states, A1, A2 through AM, and S minus M transient states, T1, T2 through TS minus M. We can rearrange the state transition matrix so the transient states come first at the top and the observing states at the bottom, like this. Matrix Q describes the transition probabilities between the transient states. Matrix R describes the transition probabilities from transient to observing states. The identity matrix I describes the transition probabilities between the observing states. If we are currently in transient state Ti, then the expected number of periods that we will spend in transient state Tj before being observed is equal to the ij's element of the inverse matrix of I minus Q. This inverse matrix is called the fundamental matrix of the observing Markov chain. In this introductory course, we just provide these results without any proof. If we are currently in transient state Ti, then the probability that we will eventually be observed in an observing state Aj is equal to the ij's element of the fundamental matrix times R. Let's see an example. This is a gambling problem we introduced in a previous video. Suppose that you start from $20 at time 0. You bet $10 each time in a gamble. You win with a probability of 0.3 and lose with a probability of 0.7 in each gamble. You will continue to gamble until you have $0 or $40. $0 means you don't have any money left. $40 means you win $20 from your opponent, and the opponent doesn't have any money left. The states represent the money you have after each gamble. This is a Markov chain. There are two observing states, $0 and $40. This is the state transition probability matrix. We arrange this matrix in a way that the observing states 0 and 40 are at the bottom right corner. The top left corner is Q, the top right corner is R, and the bottom left corner is 0. Now let's calculate the fundamental matrix. Note that this identity matrix is of the same size as Q. That means it is a 3x3 identity matrix, which is different from this one. The ij's element in this matrix represents the expected number of periods that we will spend in transient state j before being observed if we are currently in transient state I. Now let's calculate the fundamental matrix times r. The ij's element in this matrix represents the probability that we will eventually be observed in observing state j if we are currently in transient state I. Now let's answer some questions. The first question: if you have $20 now, what is the expected number of periods that you will have $30 in hand? The answer is element 2-3 of the fundamental matrix, which is 0.52. The second question: if you have $20 now, what is the expected number of periods that you will be playing the game, or the game is not over? Simply put, we are trying to understand how long the game will last. It is equal to the time you will have $10 in hand plus the time you will have $20 in hand plus the time you will have $30 in hand. It is the sum of element 2-1, element 2-2, and element 2-3 of the fundamental matrix. The answer is 3.45. Here are some more questions. If you have $20 now, what is the probability that you will lose them all? That means you will be observed by this state $0. The answer is element 2-1 of the fundamental matrix times R. It is 84%. If you have $20 now, what is the probability that you will end up having $40? That means you will be observed by this state $40. The answer is element 2-2 of the fundamental matrix times R. It is 16%. Okay, that is about absorbing Markov chains and the fundamental matrix. Thanks for watching.